sorry for that. I'm Dr. Chandrasekaran, working as a medical manager. So mainly I'm going to talk about mother-to-child transmission. I don't know how many of you have heard a term called EMTCT, elimination of mother-to-child transmission. Yeah, next slide. Indian government is planning like by 2020, mother-to-child transmission of HIV and congenital syphilis should be completely eliminated. So that's a year. By 2030, ending the AIDS epidemic. That's a plan. Now I think Indian government has come with a program for tuberculosis. Even we were talking about leprosy elimination. 2030, ending of AIDS epidemic. Before that, by 2020, elimination of mother-to-child transmission. That's a plan. Maybe I'm going to talk. Maybe something on that. To achieve that, to end mother-to-child transmission, ending EMTCT, that is a program called 19-19-19, meaning 90% of the people who are infected with HIV should know their status. And 90% who have been identified as HIV should be started on ARV. That's second 90. Third 90 is people who are started on ARV should be 90% should be virally suppressed. So if we are able to achieve these targets, definitely we are going for ending AIDS epidemic in 2030. Yeah, next slide. Yeah, what is the current status of India? Now 2.1 million people are living with HIV AIDS. Right? So if you want to achieve 11 lakh people should be diagnosed as having HIV. Currently, only 60 to 70% of the people who are infected with HIV only know that I'm HIV infected. So, and they should be put on, 1.7 million people should be put on ARV and virally suppressed 1.5 times. Yeah, next slide. So these are the states, high prevalence states in India, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu, and Manipur and Nagaland. Manipur and Nagaland mainly IV drug uses, here mainly heterosexual transmission. Next slide. So I told you that India adult prevalence is 0.26, 2.17 million people are living with HIV. Women constitute nearly 40% of the infection. And children less than 15, 7% of the total infection. So mainly what we are going to talk about is women, preventing women getting from HIV. The people who are, the women who got HIV should not transmit the infection to children. The next slide. Yeah, next slide. You know that India, HIV is mainly a concentrated epidemic, meaning we have 21 lakh people are living with HIV. HIV is very common in the female sex workers, MSMs, men having sex with men. Transgender people, we call Tirunange Aravani, intravenous drug users, and ANC. ANC is antenatal mother. Antenatal mother is a mother who is without any risk. But these people are having high risk sexual practices. Still, India is a concentrated epidemic, meaning HIV is very common among this group, but it's very low among the antenatal mothers. Yeah, next slide. So mainly we are going to talk about the vertical transmission of HIV and syphilis. Yeah, next slide. I told you that 1990. Yeah, next slide. There are certain countries globally, they have completely eliminated HIV. The second country, Thailand, you know that Bangkok is entirely thrives on sex industry, but even Bangkok could eliminate mother-to-child transmission. So when it can happen in Bangkok, why not in India? Next slide. India, HIV prevalence is very low, 0.28, but used to be nearly around 1%. Tamil Nadu, you see, Tamil Nadu is 0.27. Tamil Nadu once used to be around 0.8%. Gradually, HIV prevalence in Tamil Nadu is coming down. Tamil Nadu is a successful state, and we are nearly going for a complete elimination. But still, we have got a lot of HIV positive cases are in concentrated epidemic group, meaning high risk groups. Yeah, next slide. Nearly in India, 26 million deliveries are happening, and we have estimated there will be around 35,000 HIV positive pregnant mothers will be there. And mother to child transmission, you must be doing that without any intervention, 30 to 45%. So there will be around 10,000 babies will be there, they will be born with HIV infection. Next slide. Yeah, if you want to achieve that mother to child transmission, WHO, World Health Organization, has got some process targets. What should be done? Antenatal care coverage should be more than 94%. meaning all pregnant mothers should be registered. Tamil Nadu, we know that all mothers are registered. Even with that Muthulachirappi scheme, almost all mothers are registered. And out of all mothers should undergo HIV testing, 95%. And ART coverage, whoever identified as HIV positive should be started on ART. So if you are able to achieve that, mother to child transmission without any intervention, that is 30 to 45%, will reduce to less than 5% in breastfeeding mothers, less than 2% in non-breastfeeding mothers. We know that Tamil Nadu antenatal care coverage is around 95%, more than 95%, but India as such, it's only around 40%. Places like Chhattisgarh, Odisha, a lot of mothers are not registered. So Tamil Nadu itself, we cannot say that we are completely eliminated. Now, globalization, migrants and a lot of factors are there. Yeah, next slide. Tamil Nadu, I told you that India, 26 million deliveries happening. Tamil Nadu, estimated pregnant women is 12,64,000. Estimated deliveries 11,55,000. Out of 12 lakhs, only 10 lakh people are registering. It's only 81%. Estimated deliveries, it's only 78%. Now, I think we are from IMA, private doctors. In Tamil Nadu, 30 to 40% of the deliveries happening in private sector. We know that government have got a program for HIV control, elimination of mother to child transmission. But there are a lot of mothers who are coming to the private sector. So how would you manage? Yeah, next slide. And the estimated pregnant, yeah, previous slide. Estimated pregnant women in Tamil Nadu is like 1,587. Estimated pregnant mothers with HIV positive status should be there. But till now, we were able to identify only around 600 to 700. But still, there are 50% of pregnant mothers we have not identified. Next slide. Then, we want to achieve mother-to-child transmission elimination. How it can be done? The first strategy is, primary prevention. Now, I told you that mother-to-child transmission, women are 50% affected with HIV. Now, I was doing an analysis of Tamil Nadu HIV positive pregnant mother antenatal line list. Out of 1,200 mothers, nearly around 40% are discordant, meaning husband is negative, mother is positive. Okay? Meaning that particular lady would have acquired infection premarital or extramarital. So, our primary strategy is primary prevention. How mainly we should work with the adolescent and reproductive sexual health, girls, school, primary prevention. That is our primary strategy. The next strategy is prevent unintended pregnancies. Now you must be knowing that whenever, I think some talk on Clinical Establishment Act also. Now whenever you do HIV testing, the mother should receive, not only mother, all HIV positive clients should receive pre-test counseling. Without counseling, you should not do HIV testing. So when you are doing counseling, that mother says that I don't want to continue with this baby. If the mother asks for MTP, medical termination of pregnancy, that is your second strategy, prevent unintended pregnancies. Third strategy is all mothers should be tested for HIV, and if it is found positive, they should be started on ART. I told you that mother to child transmission without intervention, 30 to 45%. If mothers have started on ART, the transmission rate will be less than 5%. But to achieve that, the mother should be screened on the first visit itself. Mother should be on ART for more than 24 weeks. Meaning, the mother should be screened for HIV on the first visit itself. If it is positive, mother should be put on ART. You must be knowing that earlier, that is mother is HIV positive, they used to give single dose nevirapine to the mother, and after delivery the baby also given. Now, the mothers are started on complete ART. Next slide. So, main cause of HIV infection can happen during pregnancy, antenatal, during delivery and breastfeeding. Without intervention, 30 to 45%. Yeah, next slide. Now, we are going to talk about 2013 WHO option P, triple ART with breastfeeding. Meaning, earlier I told you that single dose nevirapine. 2013, Indian government has come into program, it's called option B. All mothers are started on ART when they are found to be HIV positive. And they continue to breastfeed. So the transmission rate is less than 5%. But without breastfeeding, it is less than 2%. But Indian context, still we keep on promoting breastfeeding. But Western countries, no breastfeeding. Only in Africa and India, we know that a lot of babies are dying because of malnourishment without breastfeeding. So that is more dangerous than HIV. So we continue to go with breastfeeding. Yeah, next slide. We know that the factors which increases mother-to-child transmission, high maternal viral load, new HIV infection, and advanced disease in mother. Yeah, next slide. We know that this is the viral load, this is CD4 count. This is like 3 months. The mother is in window period. Okay, initial 3 months. If you do HIV testing, test will be negative. So put it into the practice. A newly wed mother comes to your practice. You do HIV testing, test is negative. But the mother can be in window period. It is a high viral load. There is a chance the baby may get HIV infection. So what I'm trying to say is, it's not only mother screening, we have to do spouse testing also. Or whenever a couple comes, please do spouse testing, because a spouse may be having HIV positive. Yeah, next slide. Yeah, I don't know, because of time, I'm not, yeah, next slide. Next slide. We know that when the mother started on ART, viral load will come down, the transmission is reduced. Next slide. Yeah, now the latest guidance is, irrespective of WHO staging, irrespective of CD4 count, whenever a patient is HIV infected, you do CD4 count. The CD4, when the CD4 count is below 200 only, they started ART earlier in 2004. Then it was revised to 350, 500. Now, from last May onwards, test and treat whoever HIV positive are started on ART. For pregnant mothers, from 2013 onwards, irrespective of CD4 count, irrespective of HIV staging, lifelong ART for all HIV positive pregnant women. What are the drugs? Tenofovir, lamivudine, efavirenz. It's available as FDC, fixed dose combination. Tenofovir, lamivudine, efavirenz, 1 pill a day at bedtime. Why at bedtime? Because efavirenz causes neuropsychiatric manifestations. It causes hallucinations. It causes suicidal ideation. You ask the particular patient to take at night time and go for sleep. So the drugs are TLE, tenofovir, lamivudine, efavirenz, taken at time, bedtime. Yeah, night. Okay, now it's not in the mother, after delivery. The mother, you can go for normal delivery. It's not cesarean section. You can go for normal delivery. Vaginal delivery, because the mother is on ART, viral load will come down. And after delivery, you have to screen for the baby. After delivery, baby is given nevirapine prophylaxis up to 6 weeks. After 6 weeks, baby also started on Ceftron prophylaxis. 6 weeks, you want to test whether baby is infected. You cannot do the same antibody test, because the maternal antibodies will be there. You have to do a DNA PCR at 6 weeks, done in our government hospitals. 6 weeks, 6 months, 1 year, 1.5 year. 1.5 year, you will be doing an antibody test. If the antibody test is positive on baby on 1.5 year, 18 months, the baby is infected. Otherwise, baby is not infected. Up to 6 weeks, you are given nevirapine. After 6 weeks, you are given Ceftron. The baby is negative on 18 weeks, 18 months, you can take the Ceftron and continue. So because of time factor, I am not continuing that. Thank you. Thank you.
Generally speaking, if somebody is on a ART for HIV and their viral load has come down, are there risk for transmitting to their partners? Or?
Yeah, I told you about 90-90-90. Definitely, if the patient is on adequate viral, adequate ART and the viral load is very low, transmission is very much lower. Very much lower. That's the reason you go with 90-90-90. Even if I am HIV infected, if I am on adequate ART, chance for me to transmit to my wife is reduced.
Wait, it's not 100-90-90.
Yeah, practically speaking, you know about our government program. I told you that Tamil Nadu, we say that 95%. But India, Orissa, it's only 20%. So it should be practically focused. That's the reason they say. Yeah, but yeah, now 2020, we plan for 90-90, gradually 2050, 2025, 95, and 2030, 100%. You know what happened with the leprosy program, sir was mentioning about. We have, once we say that, completely eliminated. Now, every year, 1 lakh cases are coming down. So practically, our focus should be more practically focused. Thank you very much. Yeah.